Have you ever seen a photo of a car race where the car is in focus and clear, but everything else in the image is blurred out? If so, then you've just seen what adjusting the camera's shutter can do. By the time this video is done, you'll have an understanding of camera shutters and how to use them to improve your photos and videos. This video is the sixth in a series of seven total on understanding basic camera operation. I'll link to those and to many other videos on improving your photography and videography skills in the comment section below. And both during and at the end of this video as well, so stay tuned. If you want to learn more, remember to subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit that bell to be notified when I upload new videos. I upload every week on Wednesday. Hi, I'm Jim Costa. I'm a videography, photography, and technology guru, and I created this blog to help you to become a tech-savvy senior. My tips and advice are useful to anyone, but my specific focus is in helping senior citizens to become more familiar with technology to improve and better their lives. If you have a camera question, leave a comment below. I do read all the comments that people leave, and yes, I do personally respond to each and every one of them as well. Shutter speed is the most obvious contributing factor to an exposure. It has one of the biggest effects on your photos and your videos as well. With a poor knowledge of how to use the correct shutter speed, you'll end up with blurred results. The term shutter comes from still photography, where it describes a mechanical door between the camera lens and the film. When a photo is taken, the door opens for an instant and the film is exposed to the incoming light. The speed at which the shutter opens and closes can be varied. The faster the speed, the shorter the period of time the shutter is open, and the less light that falls on the film. Shutter speed is measured in fractions of a second. A speed of 1/60th of a second means that the shutter is open for 1/60th of a second. A speed of 1/500th of a second is faster, and the speed of 1/10,000th is very fast indeed. Basically, the shutter speed is the exact amount of time or exposure time that your camera records an image. As a general rule of thumb, anything below 1/60th of a second will record camera shake. Anything slower than this will require a tripod. Video camera shutters work quite differently from DSLR camera shutters, but the result is basically the same. The technical difference is that rather than using a mechanical device, the shutter speed is adjusted by electronically varying the amount of time the CCD is allowed to build a charge. So if this doesn't mean anything to you, don't worry. It really doesn't matter how the shutter works. It's the effect that really counts. The shutter opens and closes once for each frame of video. That is 30 times per second for NTSC and 25 for PAL. Thus, if a camera has its shutter set to 1/60th, each frame will be exposed for 1/60th of a second. If the speed is increased to 1/20th, each frame will be exposed for 1/20th of a second, and so on. Remember that the shutter speed does not affect the frame weight, which is completely separate and in most cases always stays the same. The main effect of higher shutter speed is that individual frames appear sharper due to the minimization of motion blur. Motion blur occurs when the subject moves within the frame while the shutter is open. The less time that the shutter is open, i.e. the faster the shutter speed, the less movement will take place. One side effect of higher shutter speeds is that movement appears more jerky. This is because motion blur tends to smooth consecutive frames together. Higher shutter speeds are common in sports coverage. If you watch any fast action sports, you'll see the flickering shutter effect. Notice how the slow motion replays look, especially when they freeze the last frame. Now, if this is all making sense to you, the tech-savvy senior in the comment section below. My question of the day is, how will you adjust the camera shutter to improve your photos and videos? If you want to see more videos like this, follow my YouTube channel, Jim Costa Films, for more. If you think what you saw was great, go ahead and like it. If you have an opinion, then comment below. you someone who could benefit from the information that I provided? Please share the video. Do you want to learn even more? If so, then connect with Jim Custer Films on social media and online on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, and the web. I currently have over 4,200 videos on my YouTube channel, Jim Custer Films, so feel free to check out many of my other videos for great tips and suggestions. Now, I also have a new Facebook group called Video Producers and Content Creators, so look for that to connect there. Join the group and get even more pro tips and tricks.